tell me that how can you become an IGF boss?
Good afternoon, everyone. I will tell you how can I become an IFS officer.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mohan and I will tell you about IFS officer.
Now, furthermore, I would like to request to my all team members to obviously show IGF. So, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kashish. So, as Mr. Ji shared that today I will tell you about my career from civil service. And my topic is an IAS officer. You must have listened about this profession because it is too much famous. But today I will tell you key features for how to become it, what are the challenges, what are the supporters, and what are the skills which are required. So let's get started. So first of all, we always can see in a team foods are most important. So food starts from that we know knowledge. What do we have knowledge? So today I will tell you that what are the eligibility criteria for becoming an IAS officer. There are different criteria, for example, age criteria, how much attempts can be given, or how many, what is the education qualification required here. So let's start from age. So what is the minimum age to apply for becoming an IAS officer? Suppose woman is 20 years old, can she apply for becoming an IAS officer? No, because for becoming an IAS officer, you must be at least 21 years old. Now, what is the maximum age? So, it depends on categories. There are three types of categories in India. First is gender category, OBC category, and SC or ST. So, it depends on categories. Let's start from gender. If you are from gender category, then your age should be maximum 31 years old. Suppose Deepika is 31 years old, but she is from gender category. Now, she cannot give IAS officer's exam because the criteria is still here. But at the same time, if Karan is from OBC category, he can give because he has more time. He can give till 35. If Ishra is from SC or ST, then she can give till 37. So this is the purpose in UPSC. And you must be thinking that it is discrimination, but it is their fault. Now let me tell about most important thing. It is education qualification. So for becoming an IAS officer, you must read 12th pass. I know you all have seen the movie 12 Fail, but he also passed 12 after getting to know that yes, we need to become an IAS officer. So you must be 12 pass. After passing 12, you must have a degree of graduation from any stream, does not matter. You did BSc, you can give UPSC. You are doing from history, economy, does not matter. You can give UPSC, which is the best thing. Now let's come on the first stage, that how can we become an IAS officer. So, for becoming an IAS officer, there will be exam. And who holds this exam? So, UPSC holds this exam for each candidate of like IPS, IAS, they all will giving same. So, the full form of UPSC is Union Public Service Commission. This does not matter for you, but I am telling. Now, let's discuss that what are these exams. So, there are three exams. First is mains. Then, first is preliminary exam, means prelims. Then there is mains, then it will be personality test, basically interview. So in prelims there will be two exams and there you need to just qualify. It will not impact on your final rank, but don't take it lightly. There you need to qualify and most of the people will be finish here only. Do you know why UPSC is doing this? It is doing this because they want to cream from the mill. So whosoever will pass prelims, they will go in the mains. Whole India will not go there. So that's right. Now let's come to mains. After clearing prelims, you need to clear mains. Like in mains, there will be written exam. There you need to be focused too much. So it is the toughest exam of India. It has found maybe for you, is it not tough? Now if you have cleared mains, now let's come to interview. There will be personality test. I'll say one thing is clear. That if you have completed mains and prelims, obviously you have too much knowledge. There is no lack of knowledge. So let's think that why are they conducting this interview? So there they will check your skills. That do you have confidence? Do you have skills of decision making? There they will disqualify you. So that's why it is for interview. Now after use, let's come to branch. In branch, there it will be written that how many, that what is the duration for becoming an IAS officer. So after 12th class, it will take 5 years to become an IAS officer. For example, if you clear 12, now you need to clear graduation. You cleared prelims, mains and interview, then you will go 2 years for training. Where? Mussoorie.
there is an academy, Lal Bahadur Shastri National Academy of Administration. There you will get 2 years training. Then, congratulations, you have become ISO. So, there will be some cons and resources. So, everyone, there are challenges in between. It is not carrot pudding. So, let's discuss. What are the challenges? So, for becoming an ISO officer, there are some challenges. For example, financial problems. So, it has found that for becoming an IAS officer, you must, not must, in my opinion, may. You may join a coaching. I will not join, that's why I am saying. So, you need to join a coaching. For joining coaching, you should have money. So, financial problem can occur there. If you are rich like Tarun, it's okay. Then we need to. Now, let's come to next point. What is next challenge which we can face, right? What is second one? So, there is exam pattern. Do you know? Each year, UPSC is changing their pattern. Each year, people are getting PYQ with previous year questions, but they are changing the pattern. So, this can be there. Now, I know you are getting demotivated. Don't get. There are leaves also for supporting you. So, what are the tips? In my life, my family. So, if you want to become an IAS officer, suppose Pooja said to her family, Papa, I want to become an IAS officer. Obviously, her family will support. Actually, it is the highest exam. Even she is trying, so family support will be there. Now, second thing is resources. So, becoming an IAS officer, there is no lack of resources. If you will go on YouTube, there will be many teachers. The best teacher of the India will teach you. So, there is no lack of resources. On Google, you can get whole syllabus, whole preparations, strategy. So, there is no problem. So, these are the things. Now, you can get this star. So, congratulations. Now, you have become an IAS officer. Everyone, I did not discuss what are the skills, so this also we need to discuss. So, in FD, there is a trunk also. Let me discuss these skills. For becoming an IAS officer, you should be hardworking. Obviously, this exam is not too much easy, it is too much hard. There, you need to hard work, you should be dedicated towards your goals. So, this is one skill which I am sharing. And second, can you communication skills? This will help you after becoming an IAS officer also and before also. Because when you will go for personality test, basically interview, there also you need to talk with people. There will be a proper board from UPSC side. So they will talk with you and there you need proper communication skills. So this skill is required. After becoming an IAS officer, you will deal with people. After all, you are becoming for people. So you need to deal with them. So this strategy should be there. This skill should be there. I hope you have assimilated my points. Now I would like to nominate my next member, Sameer. He will tell you another branch of civil services, IPS officer, how to become an IAS officer. Thank you so much.
So hello everyone, as I shared that how can you become an IAS officer, now I am here to tell you that how can you become an IPS officer. So for becoming an IPS officer, you must be 12 completed and you should have bachelor's degree from any getting. If you have these things, then you can apply for UPSC. In UPSC, you will have 3 attempts. First attempt about will be objective. There will be question about objective. You need to object them. Second attempt will be about writing. There you will need to write. Third attempt will be about your.
No,
interview and physical test. And if you have completed these all things, then you will go for 2 years training. After training, you will become an IPS officer. So, but it is not easy. So there will be some cons, and cons will be for my age physical requirement. It is this cons for me physical requirement. It is very important if you want to go in. If you want to become IPS, IAS, so it is important for you. And second thought will be training. Many people leave this job in training because it is hard, it is for 2 years training. It is not 1 or 6 months. And if we have con, then we have leaves also. Leaves will be family support. And my second leave is I have two teachers, they are supporting me. They are teaching me every little things which is important in these categories. So we have leaves and cons, and there will be fruits also. And fruits books for me, there is salary. My salary starts from 56,800 and it is last from 350. So thank you for listening me. Now I would like to nominate my next team member, Unandi. She will tell you about that how can you come and I also.
So next I will share about IPS officer. Now I should share about IRS officer. What is IRS? IRS means Indian Revenue Service. What is the work of them? So their work is to collect the data, to collect the tax from stakeholders for Indian countries' growth and development. So it is the for becoming this we need to clear. We need to pass the 12th and after that we need graduation. After that we need for this we need the 3 attempt for becoming this. So after attempt 3 exams. So after that for becoming this we need some skills also for like this. If we have data analysis skills for becoming IRS officer, so we should have data analysis skills. Means if we analyze the data for the proper way, like if we should have logical thinking, so we should analyze the data in a proper way. So we should next skills, that is problem solving skills. If we should have problem solving skills, so we should clear the problem and we should solve the problem and we should find out we should have decision making skill also for find out the solution and for take the decision for solve the problem. So for solving this and for becoming this we face some problem also. So like this we face financial problem and then for becoming this we face some problem also. So like we face financial problem. If we don't have finance, so how can we become? Because we need to pay the fees and all things. So we should face financial problems. So we should have proper finance for becoming this. And another one is huge competition. In this government job, we face huge competition because everyone wants government job in each of every. So we face this problem also. But for facing this problem, we should have support also for becoming IRS officer. So like the family and the friends support. If we have family and friend support, we are not frustrated because we study lots of and sometimes we frustrated about the study, how many things we need to remember it. So we should have family and friend support also. So we fresh our mind and we should one support also like legal expert. If we have legal expert for taking knowledge for becoming this, so we are able to become that. So if we are if we get this this IRS post in this criteria, so we should we get the salary like 56,000 to 225,000 in per month, but it depends on our efforts. And for becoming this we pay the fees, that is 1 lakh to 3 lakh in 1 to 3 years. So that's all about my this branch for IRS officer. Now I would like to nominate my next considered team member, Kavita. She will tell you about IFS officer. So
good afternoon everyone. Now I will tell you how can I become an IFS officer. The full form of IFS is Indian Foreign Service. What is the work of IFS? The work of is that they represent our Indian government front of other countries. They work with the communication, they work with other countries, they represent our country. Means they work with foreigners. So we will get a proper
any stream. You should be graduate with any stream. And then, and second, we need two things more. That is, you should be Indian. If you are from another, you should be Indian citizen. If you are, if you have another country citizen, you cannot apply for this. If you are not graduate, so you also cannot apply for this. Then after graduate, you can do UPSC exam, civil service exam. You will get that UPSC provides. Then UPSC provides, and it takes 5 years time. That you need some skills, that is problem solving, decision taking, and communication skills. Because in this job, you need to communicate it with others. And as you know, in any scheme we have phones. In this we have challenges like the high competition. In this we have high competition because everybody wants to become an IFS officer. Because IFS officer, and it's the second throne can be your throne can be the money problem, financial problem. Because for becoming an IFS officer, you need to spend money on yourself, on your for education. So it's your poor thing that can money can be spent on your study. Then we have then. As you know, I told you we will. As I told you about the UPSC exam, you have to clear UPSC exam. Now I will tell you what the exam pattern of. First, you will give pre-exam. That exam you have to take, and you will stand the option process. Then we have main exam. You should be good in writing answers. Then you have interview. In interview, they will check your skills which you have. And I have told you which skill you should have. You should have trustworthy, and you should be confident with other front of others. And that is, then you should have some set need that can be confident. If you are confident in front of other countries, if you are interconnected, your interconnected will also help will help you to get this opportunity. Then we have this flower. So we can get this flower means we can get our salary which we have spent on your study. So your salary can be, your salary is problems, you will get a big flower that can be